Listening Library presents Superworld, Save Noah, by Yarrow and Carrie Cheney. Read for you by Christopher Gebauer. Chapter 1. Game On. I'm so sick of superheroes. Okay, sorry. I'm just a little grumpy because I'm pancaked on the sidewalk with 18 broken bones right now. I think it's a personal record. Hi, my name is Noah, and I'm the only unsuper person in Superworld. I know what you're thinking. Wait, you're the only pathetic weakling in a world full of super people? Yep. I'm special that way. Special for being unspecial. There is one thing I can do that nobody else can. I can break. So yeah, shattered bones and ruptured organs are business as usual for me. But today, things really got out of hand. Let's back up about 30 minutes. I was with my friends on this crazy high cliff at the edge of town called Glacier Point. It's a nice spot, way above all the battles and nonsense. It's pretty safe up there, as long as you keep an eye out for the occasional stray energy beam or hurled car. It's also the perfect launching point for a game my friends invented called Save Noah, a surprise obstacle course designed to put me in mortal danger over and over again. One thing you've got to understand about super people, they're all sick with what I call super brain. It makes them obsessed with super stuff. They spend all day, every day, looking for excuses to switch into tights and capes. And unfortunately, I'm the world's only innocent civilian, which means I'm the only dude super people can actually save. My friends are just as affected by super brain as everyone else. So playing Save Noah helps get their super wiggles out. On the bright side, we have an agreement. Every time I let them save me, they owe me a pizza and a pre-Superworld movie. No superhero movies allowed. All right, game on. My friends backflip off the cliff and drop out of sight. Show-offs. I back up 20 feet, tighten my shoelaces, zip up my vest, and take a deep breath. I sprint toward the edge and leap. The first few seconds of free fall are amazing. I feel like I'm flying. I feel super, like everyone else. But the feeling doesn't last, because I'm seconds from a supersonic belly flop onto the jagged rocks below. So now you're thinking, of course you broke 18 bones, dummy. You just dove off a cliff. I get it. This looks bad. Mom would ground me for life if she saw me right now. But the thing is, this is actually the safest part of my day because my friends are really good at saving me. Let me introduce you. First up is Arturo. His super name is Replay. He was a prodigy pro-level gamer before Superworld. His reflexes border on Spidey-style precognition. Now, gaming is his superpower. What do I mean? Well, a millisecond before a high-speed, rocky death, Replay swoops in and scoops me up in the jaws of a digital dragon. Yup. Anything he can do in a video game, he can do in real life. He's got that, I'm a gamer, so I don't take anything seriously, thing going. He laughs a lot, mostly at me, especially when I look like a sidewalk flapjack. He can be a punk, but he saved my life more times than I can count. And he's always got my back. Replay's Save Noah turn is over, so he drops me into a beautiful mountain stream full of rainbow trout. And great white sharks. Sharks! Where do they find sharks? Here they come. Lots of teeth. But I'm cool. So many teeth! I've got about 2 seconds. 1 second. Zero! Snip, snap, snip. Streams of hair rain down from the sky, grabbing, tangling, yanking me and the sharks out of the water. Now I'm being juggled in the air like a bowling pin. With sharks! This is Tabitha. Her supername is Hairstrike. Her super hair is a picture of what's going on inside her head. 10 things at once. Her mind never stops. Tabitha's lightning-fast thinking makes her both the ultimate study buddy and the ultimate battle buddy. She can easily fight 6 villains while licking an ice cream cone and petting a puppy. Hairstrike flings me into the sky. I arc up, up, up over a rocky peak. Take a breath to settle my spinning head. Hey, it's nice up here. Then plunge down, down into a Roadrunner Death Canyon where a hulking boy giant is riding a gigantic skateboard up and down the canyon like it's a skate park. I can feel my cheeks doing that high-speed wind-flapping thing as I nosedive between the canyon walls. Smack! A massive hand snatches me out of the air. This is my buddy Hugh. His supername is Hugh Mungus. Hugh is small for our age, so he gets picked on a lot, which he loves. He's always looking for an excuse to go big and return the favor. And pro tip, make sure nothing valuable is lying around when he does. I'm pretty sure that his skateboard is his dad's car. Still in midair, Hugh Mungus preps me for the next round by tying me up in rope. He does some sort of spinny, flippy skateboard trick and lands on a cliffside railroad track doing 90. He stuffs me into a mine car, because of course they found a mine car, then pushes me down the tracks toward an old, broken wooden bridge. Because of course they found an old, broken wooden bridge. But that's cool. I wouldn't wriggle out of these ropes even if I could. Because I've got one friend left, and she's got this. A shadow streaks over the tracks in front of me, like a bird, but bigger, more graceful. The shattered bridge in front of me is enveloped by waves of warm energy. Just before rolling off the rails to my doom, wooden planks spring up from the canyon floor, reforming a lattice structure over the canyon. Rails reattach and straighten in front of me. I glide over the canyon on a brand new bridge. Meet Ivy. Her supername is Nightingale. Ivy was my first friend when we moved here. We know pretty much everything about each other. Like, I know she'd rather have no Slurpee than a cola-flavored Slurpee. She's a little quieter than the rest of us. You know, the kind of person who talks less but thinks more. Ivy notices everything. Sounds, smells, how people are feeling. I don't mean that's her superpower. It's just kind of who she is. But she is powerful. She's what's called a fixer. Ivy can fix anything from that broken bridge to my broken bones. Speaking of broken bones, I still have 0 at this point in our harmless little game, which has now transitioned to the all-play freestyle phase. Today that means I'm strapped to one of Arturo's homebrew death rockets, while my friends chase me around and keep me from exploding on canyon walls. But, like I said, they're experts at saving me. For them, this is playing in safe mode. So what happened? Well, that dude way over there in the Speedo, the one riding a subway train into a cliff while battling a swamp monster, he just spotted me in peril. So every neuron in his super brain just lit up with one thought. Must save Superworld's only innocent civilian. I shout, "Game over, guys," just as Speedo beelines toward me. "No problem," you say. "Your super friends can take that guy easy." Right, they can take that guy. But 5 more heroes just spotted Speedo rushing to my rescue, which sent a burst of mental absurdity coursing through their super brains. Then 10 more heroes saw those heroes. Then 20 more saw those. Then 30 more. My friends switch to evasive maneuver mode. It's time to play keep away. Humongous chucks me over a canyon to Nightingale. She fake out tosses me under a burning bridge to Hairstrike. Hairstrike lassos a gaggle of heroes and flings me through a half-collapsed building to replay. Nightingale patches the building, cutting off a herd of heroes, who then crash through the fresh window panes. The hero horde forces us deeper into the city, collecting heroes as we go, like a thousand cats chasing a laser pointer dot. And I'm the dot. Whoa, getting dizzy. Can't see straight.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.